टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द थोरेसिस डक्ट. इट इज द कॉमन लिम्फेटिक ट्रंक विच ड्रेन्स द काइल एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द लिम्फ ऑफ द बॉडी इन टू द ब्लड स्ट्रीम. इट अराइज फ्रॉम द जस्ट बिगिन एट द अपर एंड ऑफ द सिस्टर्ना काइली. हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज द अपर एंड ऑफ द दिस इज द सिस्टर्ना काइली एंड दिस इज द अपर एंड ऑफ द सिस्टर्ना काइली. इट इज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द थोरेसिस डक्ट एंड इट गोज इनसाइड थ्रू द इट पियर्स टू द डायाफ्राम. हियर यू कैन वी हैव कट द डायाफ्राम. इट पियर्स द डायाफ्राम. वी हैव कट द डायाफ्राम एंड अलोंग विद द इसोफेगस सिस्टर्ना काइली एट द T12 वर्टिब्रा. इट एंटर द थोरेक्स थ्रू द एओर्टिक ओपनिंग. हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज द एओर्टिक ओपनिंग. सो इट इज अलोंग विद द एओर्टिक ओपनिंग एट द T12 वर्टिब्रा पियर्स टू द थोरेसिस डायाफ्राम बिहाइंड टू द इसोफेगस एंड इट इज अ कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द सिस्टर्ना काइली एंड इट एंटर अलोंग विद द descending thoracic aorta. It enter into the posterior mediastinum. So it lies behind to the esophagus. In the thorax it upwards into the posterior mediastinum. Inside the abdominal part it is the retroperitoneal and inside the thorax it is lies inside the posterior mediastinum. On the right side of the vertebral column, this is the vertebral column, this is the towards the right side of the vertebral column and it goes upwards between the behind to the esophagus. Here you can see it is lies behind to the esophagus and towards the right side by the ajagus vein and left side by the descending thoracic aorta. In between it passes upwards and inside the neck through the superior mediastinum it enter inside the neck and it is drained inside the, this is the thoracic duct. Here you can see this is the thoracic duct which is open into the junction of the left subclavian and left internal jugular vein. It makes the left brachiocephalic vein and it enter inside the junction of the left subclavian and internal jugular vein. It open inside the left side brachiocephalic vein. So it is the largest lymphatic trunk, drain the chyle and most of the lymph of the body inside the blood streams. So at the relations of the there are different places, there are different relations. At the aortic opening, anteriorly it is related with the diaphragm. Here you can see this is a part of the diaphragm. It is a median arcuate ligament. Anteriorly, at the level of the aortic opening, median arcuate ligament. Posteriorly, it is related with the T12 thoracic vertebra, and on the right side, it is by the ajagus vein. Here you can see this is the ajagus vein, right side by the ajagus vein, and on the left side. Left side by the descending thoracic aorta. Inside the posterior mediastinum, anteriorly it is related with the diaphragm. Here you can see this is the anteriorly it is related by the part of the diaphragm and also esophagus. Here you can see this is the esophagus. So anteriorly it is related with the diaphragm and esophagus. Posteriorly it is related with the vertebral column and posterior intercostal artery. Here you can see this is the posterior intercostal artery which is longer. So this is the right posterior intercostal artery. Above it there is a thoracic duct. So posteriorly right posterior intercostal artery, on the right side by the ajagus vein and on the left side descending thoracic aorta. So inside the posterior mediastinum, anteriorly it is related with the diaphragm and esophagus. Posteriorly it is related with the vertebral column and right posterior intercostal vessels. These are the right posterior intercostal vessels And on the right side by the azygous vein and left side by the descending porous aorta. Inside the superior mediastinum, at the level of T4, at this level, where the trachea which is divided, this level, the thoracic duct which rises from the right to left side, it comes on the left side. Here you can see this is the left side, the thoracic duct which is come. And this thoracic duct, which is related inside the superior mediastinum by the arch of aorta, we have removed the arch of aorta. These are the branches, brachiocephalic, this is the left common carotid, and this is the left subclavian. So we have removed the arch of aorta. Anteriorly it is related with the arch of aorta inside the superior mediastinum, and origin of the left subclavian artery. Here you can see this is the origin of the left subclavian artery. Posteriorly it is related with the vertebral column, and on the right side it is related with the esophagus. This is the esophagus. Right side it is related with the esophagus. This is the thoracic duct. So right side by the esophagus, and left side by the left pleura, and left lung inside the superior mediastinum. So inside the superior mediastinum, anteriorly it is related with the arch of aorta, we have already removed, and left subclavian artery. This is the left subclavian artery. Posteriorly it is related with the vertebra. This is the vertebra. And on the right side by the esophagus, this is the right side by the esophagus, this is the thoracic duct, and left side by the pleura and upper part of the pleura and cervical part of the pleura and left lung. Inside the root of the neck into the upper part, and this is the thoracic duct. You can see this is the, it was just cut here at that level. You can see this is the thoracic duct. So inside the root of the neck, anteriorly it is related with the left common carotid artery. Here you can see anteriorly the left common carotid sheath, and the posteriorly it is related with the sympathetic chain. At this level this is the sympathetic chain. Posteriorly you can see posteriorly it is related with the left sympathetic chain, and also inferior cervical ganglion and vertebral artery. This is the vertebral artery. Here you can see. So posteriorly it is related with the vertebral artery, sympathetic chain, and inferior cervical ganglion and left phrenic nerve. Here you can see this is the we have cut the phrenic nerve, but left phrenic nerve. So these are the about to the relations of the thoracic duct at the different level, at the aortic opening, into the posterior mediastinum, into the superior mediastinum, and at the root of the neck. Tributaries, inside the abdomen, it is the continuation of the cisterna chyli. It is the above, it is the continuation of the cisterna chyli. And cisterna chyli, which drains the lymph from the whole of the below to the umbilicus, whole right and left side of the abdomen, as well as right and left lower limb, which is drained inside the directly by the limb trunk. It is drained inside the lower part of the abdomen below to the umbilicus, as well as the right and left lower limb, which is drained inside the cisterna chyli by the left and right lumbar limb trunk, and also there is an intestinal limb trunk. Here you can see this is the, here you can see there is a this is the ascending limb trunk, which is drained inside the thoracic duct. Ascending limb trunk, which drains the upper lumbar lymph node. And here you can see this is the descending limb trunk, this descending limb trunk, which drains the limb from the posterior intercostal lymph node of the lower six intercostal space. So these are the tributaries inside the thorax or posterior mediastinum, and also posterior mediastinal lymph node, which is directly drained inside the thoracic duct. Inside the neck, at this level, it drains the left jugular limb trunk, it drains the left subchial limb trunk and left bronchomediastinal limb trunk. So these are the lymphatic drainage of the thoracic duct, and you can see this is the thoracic duct. Visualize whole thoracic duct, you can visualize inside the posterior mediastinum of the, and above, just above to the posterior intercostal artery, you can see. So it lies above to the posterior intercostal artery, right by the ajygous vein and left by the descending thoracic aorta. And you can clearly visualize there is a cisterna chyli also. So this is about to the thoracic duct.